blah, 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 blah. This is for Monday, the 30th of March, 2020. My name's Collins. I've come to bother you again because it's Monday. I've been thinking about belief and what it means. How are you? Are you okay? I hope you're okay. Belief is kind of a squishy, imprecise word, and I wonder, is that okay, or should we be trying to, let's say, particularize it more than we have? I'll tell you why do I think that's important. Like, who cares? There are forces ambient in the world that are trying to fragment our cognition and unravel our ability to know what we think. Which I know it sounds a little crazy, but that's really going on. People are getting all confused about what it means to know things and to believe things. So I think we need to talk about what all the different ways that we say we believe things. Let's put it that way. Let's consider these following expressions of belief. I believe I've cut my finger. I believe my toe is broken. I believe Jupiter orbits the sun. I believe the liquor store is open till 9 o'clock Thursday. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. I believe the earth is flat. I believe in the power of positive thinking. I believe the scientists. I believe humans will someday travel to the stars. Okay, so now let's consider these other expressions of knowing, what we call knowing. I know the sun will rise in the morning. I know it's a sin to waste food. I know you're going to be okay. I know Jesus is coming back soon. I know I've cut my finger. Don't worry, I didn't really. So, among the things we believe, there's a spectrum of certainty. There's a point where believing and knowing converge, and that is what we call direct experience. I cut my finger. I can see it. I'm looking at it. That's different from when we have a reasonable belief in something that we kind of sure of, but we're not directly observing it. So, to some extent, we're relying on secondary sources of information, some kind of indirect experience. With the naked eye, I cannot see the elliptical orbit of Jupiter, but hundreds of years of other people observing it, I kind of believe them, and they seem credible to me. For the same reason, I also believe in electrons and photons and Higgs bosons and up and down quarks and things like that. Things that I cannot see, I believe in, because the people who have observed and measured them, I find somehow credible. On the flip side, I find less credible the assertion, Jesus loves me, this I know, because the Bible tells me so. It's entirely possible that Jesus loves me, but I don't find the Bible a credible source of information for some reason. Now, why is that? Why do some of us place credence in, one form, one source of information, and other people a different source? Does it have something to do just with our psychological makeup of, that we'll find this kind of information credible and that kind incredible? I don't know. I just don't know. I mean, I can speculate, but what good is that? We can believe things that we can never know for sure. We can believe things that we can't know for sure now, but maybe we'll know next week. And we can believe things that are not bloody likely. Interestingly, we can say we believe something, whether or not we really do believe it, because we like to belong to the group of people who say they believe that. And that kind of belief is a little scary to me because it involves lying either to others or to yourself. But I think there's a lot of that going on. I think there's a lot of people who say they believe stuff just because the people they want to belong to say they believe the same thing. It's kind of, I guess maybe I don't like it because it's anti-individualistic. I want everybody, this means you, to be responsible for what they say they know or believe. And to think independently. Yeah, I just want everybody, even your cat. Well, no, your cat's got it covered. Science is basically knowing. The words are kind of related. Let's assume, just for the sake of argument, that science and knowing are the same thing. Now, as we've seen, there's a point where knowing and believing converge, and that's when you're having a direct experience of something. Scientists, when they're being really sciencey, are very careful to distinguish what they know from what they almost know, from what they think it makes sense. They try to be very careful about that, to just be really sure when they say they know something, or they say they're speculating about something, to be clear about that. This is one of the reasons why we respect them. And I think one of the reasons for that is because the process of science happens at that boundary where between knowing and not knowing. That's where it's happening, right? So that's why they have to be so careful. Now, scientists are human too. They can have their scienciness distorted, whether or not they realize it, by persuasion or desire or even by, you know, who's paying them. And that is when you get something kind of like bad science, when people stop being completely sciencey. I'll give you a good example. In my opinion, one of my favorite sciencey people was Carl Sagan. Carl Sagan used to say all the time that if we don't destroy ourselves, we will go to the stars. Well, that's, you know, science-wise, that's bullshit. You don't know that. You can't know that. You just wish for that. So this is an example of a fairly scientific person who's just expressing a wish. And why not? He's human, right? So scientists are human, too, and they're imperfect. And since they're operating at the boundary of between what we know and what we don't know, it will happen sometimes that what they believe will affect and infect what they say they know. Now, if you flip that around, all humans are scientists, in a sense, to some extent, to a greater or lesser extent. That is to say, we're all trying to know. We're kind of born not knowing much of anything, and then over time we try to know more by way of direct and indirect experience. And this is part of what it means to be, what cognition is. It's part of what it means to be conscious, is that we're trying to know more. There's, you know, good survival reasons for trying to know more. And then there's just plain curiosity, which I think is kind of inborn in a human being, the same way they want to have sex. I mean, there's things that we're curious about that our survival doesn't depend on, but we're studying them anyway. Like, you know, distant quasars that you can't even really see with a naked eye. We want to know how they work. You know, human beings, we are all scientists, and some of us are just more sciencey than others. I think this is why I hope that we can start to get more clear about what we mean by the different expressions of belief, like the 1 to 10 of how sure you are of what you believe. I wish it wasn't so fuzzy, the word. There may be a reason why it is, but I don't think it's a very good reason. I think we should be more clear about when I say I believe that the stores open until 9 o'clock, or I believe in astrology or something like that, that those kinds of belief will be distinguishable from each other. And that's what I wish for. That's one of the things I hope for humanity. And I also hope that I will be back here next Monday to bother you some more. And in the meantime, I hope that you and all the organisms you care about will have a feine Abend verder.